Oh, dude. No way. They're finally adding Broly into Dragon Ball FighterZ? Yes, this is what I've been waiting for so long. Broly's my favorite character in all of the games. Aw, man, just look at him in Budokai Tenkaichi 3, for example. He can eat a lot of attacks before he even goes in a hit stun, he does a lot of damage, and he even has more health bars than most of the characters in the game. Man, it just feels so good to be a Broly fan when it comes to Dragon Ball games. It's almost like you're always going to get a top tier character no matter the game.
Arxis? What is this? Why am I losing to a Krillin? This never would have happened in any other game. Man, this is so stupid. If only there was a way that I could have known the strengths and weaknesses of Broly and FighterZ before I spent my hard-earned $5.
Oh, sorry. What's going on, guys? Dotodoya here with a brand new Should You Play video, this time focusing on Broly, the legendary Super Saiyan. Now, Broly is one of the more interesting characters in Dragon Ball FighterZ because of all of the things that set him apart from the rest of the cast. And while it's true that some of the things that set Broly apart are for his detriment, there are a lot of features that make Broly feel unique, which means for some players, Broly might be the exact character you're looking for, and nobody else in the game is going to fill his role exactly as he does. In order to help you find out if Broly's the character you're looking for, we're going to go ahead and cover the pros and cons of Broly as a character, and then talk about where he fits on the teams, as well as some teams that really help him out. Let's go ahead and start things off by talking about the cons of Broly. Now, con number one may seem a little obvious, but let's go ahead and cover it anyway. Broly is huge. Now, how is this a bad thing? Well, a couple of reasons. For one, when Broly's in the corner, it can feel like an uphill battle trying to get out of some of the block strings when your character is just so huge. Being as big as Broly also means you're opening yourself up to get hit by combos that only work on huge characters. Characters like Cell have Touch of Death combos that only work on big characters like Broly, so that's just another risk that comes with the size. Other negatives that stem from the size of Broly aren't as big of a deal as the previous two, but they are things to take into consideration, such as trying to go on the offensive when facing characters such as Teen Gohan and Krillin. It can be really annoying to throw a light jab, only for it to miss Krillin by two stories. And his walk speed is also horrendously slow. Broly's size and overwhelming power does come in later during the positives, but this is the cons, so don't expect too much of that here. Of course, as far as other cons go, we do have the fact that Broly is a very standalone character, so your experience from other characters isn't going to help you as much here as, let's say, transferring to somebody like Super Saiyan Vegeta. And one more thing I wanted to list in the con section, even though it's not a con in terms of his gameplay. Broly's not really a combo character. He gets decent damage, but his combos are far from what I'd consider flashy. Just seemed like something I should mention that might influence your decision on whether or not to pick up the character. With our cons out of the way, we can move on to the pros for Broly, and there are actually quite a few significant ones here. Starting with, of course, the most significant part of Broly's kit, armor. Armor. Broly's a beefy boy. Seriously though, Broly has armor on so many of his moves, allowing him to eat an attack or two and just punish the opponent for trying to click buttons when they honestly shouldn't be. Not only is this good for Broly when he's trying to exchange blows with his opponent, it also makes him extremely frustrating to deal with in the corner. So while yes, part of Broly's size makes him vulnerable in the corner, it also goes the same for when Broly has another player in the corner. Let's just put it like this, if they can't tech a Dragon Rush, then they're definitely not stopping Broly's command grab. Honestly, everything I've mentioned so far makes Broly extremely good at low levels of play. If you're low and just want to grind out some points on rank, you should probably pick up Broly, and if you're playing on console, you can expect some lovely messages in your inbox. Another good pro with Broly is that he does really good damage in very short bursts. Like I said, he doesn't really rely on combos, he just relies on a few stray hits, getting the opponent into the corner, and then a few more stray hits into his level 3, and that's pretty much going to take out just about anybody in the cast. So the pros of playing Broly actually make it kind of difficult to decide where you want him on your team. Do you want him in the point position so that he has two assists to rely on to help him out in his neutral game and to keep the opponent locked in block for even longer? Or do you want to keep Broly in the back using his assist that can't be super dashed through to get an opponent into a corner and then you switch out to Broly? I think both ways of approaching the characters have their merits, but personally I prefer to have Broly up front with whoever I'm running with him. All you really need is to land one hit and your assist should help Broly get him to the corner by himself, in which case you already have the main man out in front and center, and he's gonna handle your problems for you. I mean, once you have him in the corner, really all that's left to do is pick him up by their scruff, look him lovingly in the eyes, and then punch him so hard they see blood and combo him. And now you're up a character, simple as that. Now let's go ahead and take a look at some teams that I really like for Broly. We have Team Lockdown Saiyans, Team We Hate Goku, and Team Beam Assist. I hate you guys. And that's pretty much all I have to say about Broly. He's a really fun character as long as what you're looking for isn't flashy combos, and even then maybe some of his Touch of Death combos will satisfy you. I don't know, as far as the question of whether or not you should play Broly, I think the answer is yes as long as you're looking to play a different type of Dragon Ball FighterZ. You're not going to be doing a lot of jumping in the corner for mix-ups, you're mostly going to be going for command grabs and trying to establish a sense of pressure on the block strings. If that's not what you're looking for, then you probably shouldn't play Broly. If it is, then you should? I don't know, I hate ending these videos. Let me know down in the comments how you feel about Broly and Dragon Ball FighterZ. While you're down there, if you like these videos and want to see more like it, make sure to hit the like button and subscribe to the channel. I'm Dotodoya, I'll see you in the next video.